Good evening, everyone. Welcome, welcome. Bye, YouTube. Hello. Here we go. Jesus. How's it going, everyone? Welcome, welcome. Just putting the music back in the background. Happy Valentine's Day for everyone. Me and Dingardo. Hey, hi, Kingsguard. How's it going? Welcome, welcome. Happy Valentine's Day for Kingsguard, mostly because they already said it to Dingardo. Oh, guess what we've done? We went to Taco Bell. Oh, is it ads again? Oh, shit. I'll just wait a bit then. I really should put in like a my mom is calling be right back screen. I've been meaning to do it for like months now and I still haven't done it. Anyways, happy Valentine's Day, Kringscar. Guess where we went with Dingardo? We went to Taco Bell. I can explain. Me and my girlfriend, we're going to visit the dog when we have wait, you and your girlfriend? Didn't you guys break up? I'm confused. Didn't you guys break up like a week ago? She came back. After I trash talked her on stream. That's right. You do whatever you want, man. You do whatever you want. But yeah, Dingardo has taken me to the finest establishment in town, which is the newly opened Taco Bell, not far from here. She admitted of being a bitch. Well, admitting is not enough, in my opinion. I hope she changes. I really hope she does. Because admitting you're being a bitch is far from actually not being a bitch. So I hope she's changing. And she actually lets you sleep in during the day when you don't have work. Because that's what ticked me off a little bit. Anyways, it's fine. So also second news, I got a fine. This is my first fine since I'm driving for speeding. I was going, 70 in a 60 zone and I got a fine. I ran into a speed camera and I was driving the exact same road today as well. I don't usually drive on that road because I don't go out that way, but I was going out that way today as well. So I hope I wasn't speeding on the same stretch of road again. Because it's going down, like it's a downhill road, and they have a stationary camera there, which I didn't know or I never noticed. So I got a fine. So great. Fantastic. I Oh, why? Now I have to pay this fine? And it's like, it's a lot. I mean, it's less than 100 bucks, but still, it's 80 bucks. Like, hello? That's like almost a week's worth of groceries. I don't like this. Anyway, so what I'm planning on doing today is doing another quest in the Lantern Ride, doing some more exploration and doing a world quest. So what I'll do is I shut down the music and I switch to the game and logging in. Oh. I actually overate. I ordered a burrito in Taco Bell. I didn't realize that the burritos don't have lettuce on it. Or the one that I ordered didn't have lettuce. So it was just like a meat slab in a burrito. That was a lot. So I'm like, well, I'm now full. I still have to make myself lunch for tomorrow, which I just don't want to do. I mean, I could have done it before I actually started streaming, but I didn't feel like doing it, so I have to do it after. What was I about to... I was about to do something, and I don't know what I was about to do. Ah, yes. So, I wanted to do this, and I wanted to do some runs. Should I do ley lines? Hang on. No. First, I heal myself. Then I do some ley lines. Hang on. How's my artifact inventory doing? Because last time I checked, my artifact inventory was fogged. It's still a little bit fogged. Hang on. Okay. Do I have actual decent sets for Ayato? Like a decent pieces for Ayato? Where's Ayato? Artifacts. What? I don't even know what my Ayato is. Yeah, that's not bad. Oh, please don't. Right. So what I want to do... I want to set this one. Oh, I love that it gives you the... Okay. Okay, compare. These are shit. Compared to that one, these are pretty poop. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Alright, let's... nope. What about these ones? Yeah, we're going back into that domain. I mean, that one has potential. Let's try and enhance the thing. Yeah, no. Oh, hey, hi, Chuchok. Bye, Chuchok. Alright, it's decided we're going back into that one domain. Also, I forgot to go to pee. Also, either tomorrow or the day after, I want to do... Honkai. I've been meaning to do so many games. I've been meaning to play so many different games. I want to do Star Rail. Because I left the Trailblazer quest like halfway. Which one I want to do? I want to do Honkai. And there is a bunch of indie games that I want to play on stream. And I just don't have the time. Like in the past 2-3 weeks, I just had zero time. And in the next few weeks, I'm gonna have zero time as well. So when that's gonna happen, who the fuck knows? But, there are big changes coming. My fermented boy is dead. Fuck. I forgot to heal him. I remember I accidentally killed him. All right, let's heal the fermented boy. Let's back into the domain we go. Oh. All right, do the domain runs to build us. Hopefully we're gonna get some nice ones this time around. Oof. Are they? Also, so weird that we don't have to run up from all the way down there. It quite literally spawns you right outside.
The tide beckons.
Okay, that's one down.
As you wish, main Fräulein.
Be sanctified.
Oh my god. This thing is so much easier to beat when I have Farina in the team with him. Condensed resin. Garbage. Absolute garbage.
Let the fighting be humble. Settle down.
Hey, that's rude.
Wings of darkness, come, sever night from day.
The tides beckon.
Something is healing Fischl from time to time. I noticed that. It might be the weapon. I have to have check. I have to have a look.
Found your head.
Okay, fish, is your weapon healing you? No, it doesn't. Okay, something is healing Fischl and I can't figure out what it is. It might be Dea. Oh, an actual nice flower. Would you look at that? What a rare sight. Right, okay. Let's continue.
Let the mighty be humble.
I can't see what's happening. Oh, for fuck's sakes.
Shadow Raven, let night fall.
It's her ultimate that's healing her, I think. But it might be Dea. Dea's side effect. Or even Fermanet's side effect. I don't know. Someone's effect. Someone is doing something. Fischl, no heal. Something is healing Fischl, but I can't figure out what it is. When she does her ultimate, something is healing her. It might be Dea.
I created another.
Dea, do you have a talent that's healing the fish? When the character is less than 40%, Dea will recover 20% of their max HP, will restore 6% of her max HP every 2 seconds or the next 10 seconds. I think it's Dea. Because fish goes under 40% and then there just pops it back up. I think it's there. Oh my god! Garbage! Absolute garbage! I'm gonna do this 3 more times, then I pee, then I do the random ride, then I do some side quests random.
Oh, reveal thyself!
Hey, no. Never that. Give me energy.
The tides beckon.
But then, with that logic, she should also heal Novilan. But she doesn't. I don't know. Give me energy. Give me energy. More passion, more passion, more passion, more energy, more energy, more energy, more footwork, more footwork, more footwork. Whatever, it should go working out. I feel so bad after eating Taco Bell and sushi today, because I went to grab some sushi today for lunch. And then I had the Taco Bell with Dingardo. And now I feel like super bad about it. But it was good though. I don't know how Taco Bell is in the US because I never had it before. But it's not bad. It's actually pretty pleasant. I would say I put Taco Bell ahead of KFC over here. But even KFC is not too bad.
Settle down. Be sanctified.
That's how it's done, power washing the enemies. Wait. Taco Bell is like rare over here. We have McDonald's and we have KFC. But for instance, Burger King and Taco Bell are rare over here. I don't even know where the closest Taco Bell is. Not the closest Taco Bell, closest Burger King is to here. Because back home in Hungary, Burger King is like any other, like it's quite, like you can find Burger Kings anywhere. But over here is like actually rare to find a Burger King and a Taco Bell. But there's a Taco Bell that just opened like very close to where we live. Oh no, Burger King is still around. It's just bigger. I think it's Burger King is just bigger outside of the US than in the US for some reason. I know that Australia has Burger King and it's called, what is it called? I think it's called Hungry Jack's. Don't quote me on that. But yeah, Burger King is still around. And when I go home, like to Europe, Burger King is actually my favorite fast food out of all the fast foods that are at home. But over here, I would say, I think it's hard to tell. I like Mecca's chicken wraps. But I don't know, like next time when I'm in Taco Bell, I want to try out their bowls because those look nice. But yeah, all right, give me 1 second. I really have to pee. I'll be right back. Yes, Bendy's a thing over here. Yes, it's just very rare. I know that there was one close to where Dingardo used to work, but it closed down like a few months ago because it was just not going well. All right. I'll be right back. Hello. Okay, so I was thinking, I'm looking at the,
the New Zealand police.
And I was thinking, it could be worse. I mean, I was just drinking wine. I never drink and drive, but I'm like, well, you know what? It could have been worse. There was times on the motorway, like the motorway here is 100. And when I'm just like looking and there's no one in front of me and I'm just keeping my foot on the gas. And by the time I notice, I'm at 120 and I'm like, fuck, shit, fuck. So I take my I take my foot off and I'm slowly slowing back down to 100. But when if someone would catch me in that would be a big fine. So I'm actually glad that I only have this one. It could be a lot worse. But it could be better as well. I could be not paying a fine. That's the fever. Oh, this looks cool. I never actually seen this. How it works. Oh, the Shing Cho's outfit. I'm still kind of sad that I forgot to tell him what happened to the unnamed heroine. Or the nameless heroine or whatever it's called. I just done this one. All right, I'm doing pretty good. I'm doing pretty good. All right. What I want to do is this one. Meet up with gaming. Right. Let's meet up with gaming. That was a nice pee. You know when you have, like, when you go to the bathroom, you have, like, a very satisfying pee or poop, and you just feel so satisfied after for a while? That's what's happening for me. Is that supposed to be Slongli, by the way? Doesn't really look like Slongli. Oh, a life of suffering with Shing Cho. Hey, gaming.
Paimon sees you've certainly gotten an early start this morning.
Hello.
Playing games already, are we? Who won this time? You the one buying dim sum again?
Well, your vine looks so sad.
Hey, when you put it like that, it makes it sound like I'm always the one losing.
You kind of look sad.
Ah, perfect. You're all here. There's an important commission I need your help with.
Who are you? Right, where did you come from?
Where are the goods?
Well, it's not just goods this time. I need you to escort a tea merchant and their wares from Chaoying Village to Liyue Harbor. A very important client has requested to meet with him.
Sure. What's this merchant's address?
Here.
Oh no, I like it there.
If the client's that important, then this must be a very crucial, very pressing commission, right?
I like his hair as well. I like his design overall. He's my new favorite 4-star, I think.
Of course, the sooner you complete it, the better. I would advise you to depart as soon as possible.
I'm fine by me.
Alright, don't work too hard now, Longjo. We'll set off then.
Okay. I bet it's his dad. It's his father. What? Oh.
You're a bit quiet today, Gaming. Oh, do you want Paimon to tell a story?
Where are we going?
We're almost there. I'll take a rain check on that.
So, this is where the gaming boy is supposed to live?
Hello. Used to? You must be the tea merchant heading to Liyue Harbor. We're here to escort you.
Oh no. Yip-tack?
Dad?
Dun-dun-dun!
Oh, so you're Gaming's father. It's nice to meet you. Just leave this delivery to him. Trust Paimon, he's got this in the bag. Gaming is super good at what he does. Everyone at the Secure Transport Agency says as much. Even the Ministry of Civil Affairs has nothing but good things to say about him.
Seems like you've made some sort of name for yourself, at least.
The goods are all in order?
Yes, they're all here.
Then
punch him, Gaming. Let's punch him. I don't know how I'm gonna do it.
A very important client has asked for you by name. You kinda have to come with us. Paimon doesn't know how we would explain ourselves if you just didn't show up. Plus, you'd be missing out on
okay,
a huge
that's why I do it. Nice.
I see. I suppose I will have to trouble you all to escort me, then. Let's go.
Alright, well, let's go to Liwa Harbor. Okay. So now we are just spawning back. Oh, we are coming here. Okay. I'm just gonna walk here. I could teleport to Wangshu Inn and then just glide down, but what's the fun in that? Nothing. That's what's up. You're welcome for the free concert anytime. God. Why didn't I just teleport to Wangshu Inn and then walk? It's beyond me. But you know what? I have my reasons. I always have my reasons. I'm gonna collect everything while I'm here. It's been a while since I've been in this place. Oh, look at them fireworks. And some blue finches. They're very cute though. Okay, Gaming. Where's your dad? Ah. There.
We've been walking for so long. Is anyone tired? How about we stop and rest for a bit?
I'm fine.
It's just a dragon watching. Just a dragon.
Don't you usually have some delicious snacks on you? Come on, bring them out so we can share them.
I'm fine. Thank you.
The winter melon cake he gave us last time was so delicious. Have you ever tried it before?
Oh yes, the year of the dragon. We just have some dragons.
This place looks nice and open. Why don't you all rest here for a second?
Huh? What about you? You're not going to join us?
I'm not tired. I'll keep watch.
Oh, but...
just let him go.
Okay, this is not awkward
we'll
at all.
Let's share amongst ourselves then. Did you know, Uncle Ip, that the flavor of these cakes changes depending on...
Halt! Who goes there?
Huh? Huh? Huh?
It appears that one's movements were overly conspicuous.
Enough of your musings. Focus. Focus on the matter at hand.
Look at them, he's so fierce.
Present your exquisite ornaments at once.
Present
indeed.
Your exquisite
bring
ornaments.
Bring them forth readily and without protest.
Ah! What do we do?
It seems as if these two are acting alone. It won't be difficult to subdue them, but they might have something else waiting in store for Dad. The best way to keep him safe is... Leave this to me. I'll handle them. Traveler, Paimon, take my dad and the goods away from here.
No, Kaming. It's too dangerous.
This is what I do.
A thorny foe, indeed.
A thorn!
Let us depart and seek a target softer in blows and disposition.
Don't think I'm gonna let you off so easily.
Away. Let us away.
Coming!
Don't worry, he's a great fighter.
Yeah, well, that's his profession.
Paimon's even seen him take down a dozen or so treasure hoarders all by himself.
But Coming, I...
The gamer! He's a pro gamer!
If he had just stayed by my side and learned a family trade, he wouldn't have to put himself in such dangerous situations.
I love them! They're so funny! Him.
Let's go on ahead! We'd best get away from here, in case there are other bandits in the area waiting in ambush!
All is going to plan.
Okay, we should be good to stop here.
Is that the Slongli?
Oh no, what is he doing here?
Slongli!
Good sir, please, listen to me. Reel in your line and leave this place as quickly as you can. There are bandits in the area.
Is this flying a kite? I love him!
Bandits? Acting in broad daylight. Oh.
Paimon, you okay? Let the man fly a kite.
I see. It appears many people are catching a chill as of late. If your throat is bothering you, Paimon, perhaps some tea and rest are in order.
He must have figured it out by now. He's just playing dumb on purpose.
If there are indeed bandits in the area, then we should inform the Millilith at once.
The guard was escorting us is already on their trail.
Oh? Well, if that's the case, such matters are best left to those with the necessary expertise, wouldn't you agree?
I suppose you're right. If ordinary people like us got involved, we would only cause more trouble.
I love that he's just like, a retired grandpa flying a kite out on the countryside all by himself. Especially if it's like a ghost, like Hoot Owl's ghost kite. He's flying that, oh my god. Slongli.
Since we find ourselves otherwise unoccupied in this beautiful area, why don't we find a quiet place to relax while we wait for good news?
That would be lovely.
All right, so... The gamer is still chasing the bandits. Ooh, apples. I'm not gonna stop calling him gamer, I don't think. Even though if it's annoying. Local gamer kills a Deptide deer or mistaken for a bandit. Oh my god, love it!
So, Uncle Ip does have a reason to be worried. After all, Gaming, the guard we mentioned, is his son.
Gaming. The name sounds somewhat familiar. Ah, yes. That is the name of the Usho dancer who has been performing around Liyue Harbor recently.
Is it Wusho or Usho?
Oh, have you seen him perform?
Indeed. I cannot help but admire his skill. He truly encapsulates the spirit of the Suani. Usho dancing has become more well-known in Liyue Harbor recently. However, although performers are seeing budding success, they have no doubt had to face many hurdles along the way. Ones not so easily understood by spectators such as ourselves. If you ask me, what truly deserves admiration is perseverance in the face of adversity.
Thank you!
That is a rare attribute indeed.
Slongli came at the best time. Look at him, he's contributing to the plan nicely. Is he even part of the plan?
I have heard many of my acquaintances praise Gumming for his kind, selfless, and courageous disposition. To have a child so accomplished and upright, you must be a very proud parent indeed, Uncle Yip.
Uncle Yip!
Seems like Slongli has decided to skip the formalities.
He's a hard worker, yes.
You should be sure to tell him you think that when he cuts back.
Your son is young yet. It's normal for someone his age to be a bit hot-headed. It's understandable to find talking about such things in person difficult. If there's a particular sentiment you wish to convey, perhaps we could pass it along for you.
No. It wouldn't be right to ask that of you. This thing between us has festered for many years now.
I want to see him beat up his dad.
There are some things that simply aren't easy for us to talk through. I've been in the tea business for most of my life, and I always hoped my child would do the same. Otherwise, how would he support himself? Over the past few years, I heard how well he was doing for himself as a guard. How his work was taking him to farther and farther off places. I also heard that he never gave up on wushou dancing. It made me happy. But I was also worried. When you're young, you can handle all that physically taxing work and manual labor. What young person isn't capable of making a living that way? My concern is what happens when you get old.
Or just don't be a failed father. I have no idea what this dude has done wrong, but he has. So him and Gumming got in a fight. Have you played the Lantern Rite? Have you paid attention? Anyways, I'm still gonna tell you. So him and the gamer boy got into a very heated argument that almost ended in almost got physical over him wanting gamer to take over the family business of tea or like tea making or tea trade or something. But Gamer Boy didn't want to do that, and that's pretty much the basis of it. What was this about? So him wanting, like, the father, wanting Gumming to take over the family business. Gumming wants to follow his dreams and not want to take over the family business. They got into a very heated argument. It's been festering for a long time. It peaked in an argument, and Gumming left home, and he never returned after that. This is the first time they see each other in like years.
Every time I get to thinking like that, I cannot help but be reinforced in the belief that I was right. That I was right not to give in. I often regret introducing him to wushou dancing as a kid. If I had known how things would turn out, I would have never taken him to see those performances in the first place.
It is only natural for a parent to strive to send their child down the right path. No one would begrudge you that sentiment, Uncle Yip. You need not worry.
You seem quite young, Mr. Zhongli. Yet you speak with such wisdom. Perhaps I have misjudged your age.
You have.
Your words are too kind. Truth
he
be told,
looks so skinny.
One of my old friends has
Look
several
at him.
Grown
he looks
daughters.
So skinny.
Rather than fretting about their future, however, she prefers to let them find their own way.
Is she talking about Cloud
She's
Returner?
She's more easygoing than I could ever be. I fear I lack such an open mind.
She called Ganyu and Shenhe Cloud Retainer's daughters? I love it.
I meant to say earlier, there is no need to be so polite. Feel free to call me by my name, Yip Duck.
Sure.
Yip Duck. I want to be that skinny.
Do you also think I fret too much, Mr. Zhongli?
A little bit.
That's not exactly what I was hoping to convey. Only a fool would ask a parent not to worry about their child. But think of it this way. Raising a child is not unlike flying a kite. Hold the string too tight, and it can no longer soar. As my friend once said, if your children are aiming for the stars, clipping their wings will only cause them to come crashing down. You need to let out the line for a kite to soar.
That's a nice analogy.
You need not reproach your heart for caring. You simply need to loosen your hold a little. Indeed, with such a big heart, why not allocate the time you usually spend worrying about Gamin to the pursuit of other things? Like going for a stroll, drinking tea, or taking in the scenery. You never know what surprises could be in store. Things can change in the blink of an eye.
The blink of an eye, you say? Do things change so quickly?
Children grow up in quite the same way, do they not? Day after day, year after year, sometimes in the blink of an eye, but always when you least expect it. As a father, I'm sure you know that best.
Yes, you can say that again. One second, Gaming was a kid. The next thing I knew, he was ready to fly the nest.
Zhongli certainly has a way with words.
He always had his way.
Oh, Gaming is back!
Did you kill the Adepti?
Hey, Gaming, we're over here!
Dad, Traveler, Paimon. Good, you're all here. Oh, and Mr. Zhongli from the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor? You're here too?
No, he's not here.
A fated meeting indeed. We were just enjoying some pleasant conversation.
Is everything resolved?
Well, you could say that.
What does that mean?
Traveler, Paimon, come with me. I need to talk to you.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Did the two Adepti spit?
I'll come right out and say it. Those two bandits, you sent them, didn't you?
What? No.
So, that's how we're starting off?
Can't look me in the eye, huh? Guess I'm right then.
Okay, but how did you know?
At first, their mannerisms seemed a bit stilted. But once I got close, it was obvious that they possessed great skills. I was right on their tail, and it should have taken only a few steps to catch up to them, yet somehow, I was never able to close that distance. People with that level of skill would have gone about things differently from the start, like sneaking up on us while we were distracted. Unless, of course, their real motive was to lure me away from the group all along.
You're pretty quick on the uptake.
I just have a lot of experience. I've dealt with many a ruthless bandit in my time, but I've never seen ones like them. In the end, I told them they would make good guards if they ever wanted to get back on the straight and narrow, and that they could hang out with me and Liyue Harbor anytime.
You ever consider you might be a little too good at making friends?
I'm guessing you guys were trying to help resolve things between my dad and me?
I guess so, yeah.
I appreciate it, I really do. But this conflict between us has been going on for a long time.
And it's not nice to meddle in family business you have nothing to do with.
I was able to subdue them and show them what I was capable of. It wouldn't change anything. You've seen the way he talks to me.
It's not like that at all! Your dad really cares about you. You should see the way he talks about you when you're not around. Zhongli was talking things through with him and he nearly agreed to let it go. You don't believe us?
He won't let it go. He can say as much as he wants to other people, but he won't talk to me. I'm certain of it.
Gaming has a mean character, right? He really does. But I love that for him. He's such a good boy. I like him so much.
You told us you wanted to prove yourself to your dad. Why don't you tell him about all the
I genuinely feel like building him.
Will that even do anything? I'm not sure talking is enough.
You won't know unless you try. Just like how you won't know if something is delicious unless you taste it. Listen to us. It's time to put these people skills to good use. You can make friends with anyone, so why not your dad?
Good luck, we'll be rooting for you.
I'll do my best.
You are very knowledgeable, Mr. Zhongli. I'm impressed.
Are we going to see the first gaming and NPC fight?
For several decades, it seems. I still have much to learn about the art of tea tasting.
You flatter me. It was nothing but a few humble musings.
How much tea have you drank since we've been gone?
Not like it was alcohol.
Ipdoc and I have found many a common interest. Our friendship, much like a cup of tea, seems to grow stronger the longer it has to steep.
Well said, Mr. Zhongli. Gaming, Mr. Zhongli is very knowledgeable. You should take the opportunity to learn from people like him when you're in the city.
Huh? Oh, of course.
Ahem. Zhongli?
I have very much enjoyed our conversation, Ipdoc. But I, unfortunately, have some unfinished funeral parlor business to attend to.
Oh.
Did they rope Zhongli into it on purpose, though?
My apologies for taking up so much of your time, Mr. Zhongli. No need to stay on my account. When you're less busy, let's find the time to meet. I'll treat you to dim sum.
It would be an honor.
Especially the Zhongli is still broke as fuck. Also, Leo Harbor is not that way. Leo Harbor is not that way.
You two have a nice chat, all right?
Oh shit. Slong. Oh, I don't want to go near them, but I kind of want to listen.
Should we sit?
Sure.
Okay. Gamer! I hope he's gonna do his best.
Thanks for helping us talk things through with Uncle Ip. Good thing you were able to pick up on what we were putting down.
I have been around the both of you for some time now. You could say I have a certain level of expertise in that regard. As for my role in the conversation, think nothing of it. I hardly did anything noteworthy.
How are you out here on your own?
You never change, do you? Why did you have us walk all this way? Paimon thought we just had to go far enough to be out of earshot.
A friend approaches.
A friend?
Hello.
Oh, hey!
Xiao, you're here too?
Hey, Xiao!
I've been here the whole time. A ghostly kite. Could that elusive Director Hu be coming to Wangshu Inn once again? What is she doing here? I suppose it matters not. Given her relationship with Rex, well, Zhongli, I might as well go pay my respects.
I love this!
I thought you were Director Hu.
Ah, your arrival is most fortuitous. Do you want to try out this new gadget?
It's so cute!
The addition of the power source makes the takeoff more stable. It's just that...
He seems quite immersed in the study of this device.
I fear it's almost too stable. It completely negates the pleasure of seeing one's kite sway with the wind. It's a bit of a shame. In truth, I'm here because Director Hu dispatched me to purchase some items in preparation for Lantern Rite.
Aww.
I see. Much like she does every year. Much like she'll do next year, I would imagine.
Probably.
Am I wrong? Or has she once again sent you out to buy, what is it, sesame oil or something?
While we're on the subject, I do wonder why she is so obsessed with using sesame oil in the preparation of mixed vegetable dishes for Lantern Rite. A recommendation from Shangling, perhaps. What do you think, Xiao?
I love these
two! I've only met Director Hu a few times. I'm hardly the best person to ask.
Ah, and is that not a sign that you should visit Wang Sheng's funeral parlor more often? It wouldn't hurt to grace the parlor with your presence now and again, when you are otherwise unoccupied.
Are you guilt-tripping?
This one here is a traditional kite, one without any equipped mechanical device. Director Hu tasked me with studying the differences between the two to determine which one is of greater merit.
Zhongli is like subtly, just like pushing the blame or like making Xiao feel guilty for not visiting him more often. He's acting like a real dad. Are you serious?
Many hands make light work. Perhaps you could test out the other kite for me?
I was like, yep, that feels like a kite. All right.
I have made my comparisons. If speed is what you're after, the mechanical kite is the better choice.
Wonderful. I shall pass that information along to Director Hu. I'll leave these two kites with you. Perhaps you can find a few friends with which to partake in the activity. You might find it to be an enjoyable use of your time.
Oh, wait. Who enjoys kite flying?
Well, I would imagine someone of your talent and wisdom is more than capable of finding out.
Are you trying to set us up on a date?
You were testing out the kites for Hu Tao and even roped Xiao into doing it for you? Paimon didn't ask earlier because the situation was awkward.
I would hardly say I roped Xiao into anything. I simply sought the help of a friend. Besides, we did the testing together.
Seems like our pool of competitors is growing.
The competition is not important right now.
Do you like kite flying, Xiao?
I suppose I neither like nor dislike it. Although, watching a kite gradually ascend into the sky does bring me a certain peace of mind. Perhaps they're a bit like Xiao lanterns in that way.
Mm. I guess so.
Kite flying is also a pleasant form of relaxation.
Oh, he cares about Xiao so much.
Cloud Retainer taught us how. We can teach you if you want.
There's no need. Minogius was the only Yaksha among us who had an interest in matters of ornamentation and design. When Lantern Rite is over, come find me near Pervasi's temple if you have the time.
Sure.
It's getting late. I should go inform Director Hu of our findings.
Yeah, but your event was...
How's she been, by the way? The funeral. You should say hi to her for us.
The last time I spoke to her, she mentioned that she would be visiting Chaoying Village in a few days. If you have the time, perhaps you could also make the trip. If you happen to run into her, you can pass along your regards in person.
Oh, so they're telling us where to find them after the whole quest line is over. That'd be nice.
See you next time.
Okay, bye, Slongli. It's nice to see these old characters from time to time. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Coming.
You can go first.
I don't have anything to say.
Okay.
Then I'll go. I still don't want to leave Liyue Harbor.
Oh. I can't say I support that decision, but... Hey, let me finish before you get all worked up.
Sit, Shenhe, sit. You must be tired from your journey. Shall I pour you a cup of tea, or would you prefer something else to drink?
What is happening
no
here?
No need. I'm not tired.
They're gone, Master.
Perfect. The time is nigh for us to make an appearance. Do you remember the plan one recounted to you?
Yes, Master. We aim to give them a demonstration of familial love.
What the hell?
So I'll have whatever you are having.
All right.
What are Auntie Xianyun and Shenhe doing here? Just how many people are involved in this scheme? I suppose all I can do is just take a seat and see what happens.
Perfect. I just so happened to have bought some Songlo tea recently. It's quite the delectable variety. Or it would be if one has not been forced to drink it every day in the hopes of whittling down one's considerable stash. One has more than had one's fill already.
I thought you were gifting them!
Forget it. Such thoughts detract from the present need to keep up the conversation. Has work been busy during the holiday season? Do you need my help with anything?
Drunk guests can sometimes cause trouble, but I deal with them as you taught me, by pinning their heads against the table.
Hey, what? Hey?
Are Auntie Xianyun and Shanhe serious right now?
What the hell?
Oh dear. While one was busy orchestrating this act, one seems to have forgotten about Shanhe's various eccentricities. What I meant to ask was, have you made any new friends? We live so far from each other, it would be a great comfort to me to know you were surrounded by good companions.
You already know of my past circumstances. Recently, I've been conversing with Guoba in the kitchen at night. Guoba can't talk, but his companionship is a comfort.
What the hell is going on?
Her one friend can't even talk. I guess maybe Gaming is not doing so bad after all. Perhaps I've been too hard on him.
Let's move on, shall we? Do you have any plans for today, Shenhe? How about we do something fun?
That sounds about right. Take her to do something fun, and perhaps she'll loosen up a bit.
Like we used to do when we would carry stones up and down the mountain from dawn until dusk, picking herbs to eat for dinner along the way? If that is what you ask of me, then that is what I shall do.
Dad, here, have some tea. Or no, wait, best not have any just yet.
Yeah. Oh, I simply can't listen to that any longer. Coming. I'd like to finish what I was trying to say before.
Ah! Is the bird bitch surprised that Shanhe handles rude people like that? I mean, she does seem to be surprised about it, yes?
I don't support your decision to stay in Liyue Harbor, because living there is too hard on you. If you come home, there will be people to help you. I'm not saying we have to live under the same roof. I know our personalities are too similar to avoid butting heads. But you'll have your entire family around you. Your aunts, uncles, they'll all do whatever they can to help. You could get a less taxing job, and we could grab dim sum together from time to time.
Dim sum is the love language.
I didn't know dim sum was such an important affair, Master.
Shh.
Just think about it, okay? You don't have to decide now.
Dad really has changed a lot. He would never have said these things to me before.
I wonder where she learned them. Exactly.
But I... Thank you, Dad.
Shanhe double employed as a bodyguard? Pretty much.
It's been long enough, don't you think? Hope. I'm unsure hopes they've made up by now.
I mean, they didn't make up, but they did progress.
They're drinking tea in silence. That's not a good sign. Did Xianyun's plan not work after all? Hey, you two! Paimon's sorry we were gone for so long. We got to chatting with some friends and didn't realize how much time had passed.
Perfect timing, actually. We seem to be just about done here.
Yep, let's go. I'll get the bags.
It's not as bad. It could be worse.
Gaming has grown a lot taller, hasn't he?
He's so cute. I like him so much. I'm gonna build him. I don't know how to build him, but I will build him. Oh my god, and you two, this was a train wreck to watch. I love
Master,
it.
Did I say something wrong earlier? I tried to go along with your questions, but when I saw how you and that man reacted, I started to wonder.
Not at all. Certain unforeseen variables may have presented themselves along the way, but the outcome proved favorable. The plan was a success.
Then I helped?
Yes, you did, Shen.
Naturally. Your purity of spirit is one of your greatest strengths, Shen He. You need not change who you are.
I love these two. Oh my god, I love them. All right. Well, you two have fun with tea. I'll go to Lira Harbor. God, this was so entertaining. I love it. Wait. Okay. Oh, look at the magnificent gate of Leo Harbor. I remember there was a time when I walked down from Mondstadt all the way to Leo Harbor when only those two areas were released. That was something to do, I guess. Charlotte, stop. Why is Charlotte here? I kind of forgot that she's here.
You must be Mr. Ip. Thank you for coming all this way.
Okay, Charlotte is the client.
And I'm a reporter from Fontaine. You can find me writing for the Steambird. I invited you here not just to purchase your fine tea, but also with the hope that you might be willing to sit down for a short interview. What do you say?
Oh my god, Charlotte, so you made this man come all the way from Yilong Village to Lira Harbor in the hopes that you can set up an interview with him? What if he says no and then he needs to go back? The fuck? This is not well planned out.
An interview? To advertise my teas?
I suppose you could think of it that way. We Fontanians are big tea drinkers too.
The Fontaine Market. Then I'll need some time to adequately prepare. Perhaps
this could have been an email.
In advance.
Of course, of course. Please follow me.
This could have been an email.
Is this person also involved in your plan?
What do you think?
Here, I thought I had lots of connections. I suppose I've been humbled. You sure know all kinds of cool and important people.
Over here! Yoo-hoo! Over here!
Huh? What? Auntie Shenyun?
Shenyun!
He probably wants to talk about the next phase of the plan. Let's go while your dad is still distracted.
The fuck? Are we just gonna involve him in the plan? I guess so. Sub booba bird. Burb.
I take it that all is going well.
Don't worry, Shenyun. Everything is going according to plan.
I wouldn't take it kindly if someone was like doing
it
an
act earlier.
Like Auntie conspiring really against something. Me.
She was so determined to help me. She didn't even care about making herself and Shen He appear foolish in front of my family. She truly knows how to look out for others. I still have a lot to learn.
As for the next step...
Oh no!
What?
What's wrong, Gaming?
Don't tell me you're the ones footing the bill for all that tea. I can't let you do that!
Fret not. Reimbursements will be made.
Think of it more as an investment, as Ningguang would say. We pulled together the mora so that Charlotte could place the order. She's gonna bring it back to the Steambird as a gift, as well as a sample of the regional specialty.
There you go.
Fontanians will probably fall in love with your dad's tea as soon as they lay their eyes on Charlotte's article. And once all the money from the new orders begin to roll in, getting our mora back will be a piece of cake.
There you go.
Oh, okay. Business-related matters always seem to go over my head, but I refuse to let you all lose Mora on my behalf. I'll pay you back right now.
No!
We can talk about such matters at a later date. There are more important matters for you to consider at the moment, are there not?
Yes.
Yes, you tell him! You tell him!
I've been thinking about it the whole way here. I have an idea, but I'd hate to cause even more trouble for all of you.
That is for us to decide.
Yeah, we're all friends here. Plus, we wouldn't be here if we didn't want to help, right? Just tell us about this idea of yours.
Okay. Whew. So, it's like this.
Let's split up and make it happen. We need to do those things we talked about, but we also still have the kite flying competition.
Yeah.
Since Xiao already tested out those kites for us, why don't we also go buy one of those mechanical thingamabobs or whatever they're called? We can attach it to our kite.
Okay. Let's go and investigate the stolen. Am I going to find any familiar face? Also, I remember when Theater Mechanicus was just like right here where they are sitting. Here was Theater Mechanicus.
Do your teas pair well with milk? What about sugar?
Can we skip that question?
Of course! You would much prefer that the teas be made plain, I suppose. Perhaps you could provide some descriptions of their flavor profiles during the interview.
Ah, no problem.
Noted. Now then, let's discuss tea box design, shall we? Recently, I've learned a lot about traditional Liyue motifs and their deeper meanings. I was thinking if there was some way to integrate these motifs into the design of the exterior packaging.
Now that's an interesting idea. If you ask me, I would probably...
And that's the end of what we hear. Okay. Let's buy some mechanical mechanics. Hi, we're here to buy some kites as the sun is setting over the harbor.
I see you returned from your trip. I really do have to thank you for all your help from before.
You're welcome.
Thanks to you, my daughter was able to build a kite with her grandmother that very same day. She even wrote a long letter telling me how much she loved it.
Oh, you should really be thanking Gaming, not us.
I'll be sure to.
Oh, look at so
are
wholesome.
Are you here to buy a kite? Please, take your pick.
Oh, we already have a kite. We wanted to buy one of those, device thingies from Fontaine. Do you sell them separately?
Ah, yes. Here you go. Please, take it, free of charge. The directions are in the box. It's not hard to install at all.
It doesn't feel right for us to just take it.
Well, nor would it feel right for me to take your Mora. Good luck in the kite flying
Look
competition.
At everyone being
I'll
so
be
nice.
For
That's
you.
Why I like these events.
Right,
they're wholesome, mostly. Some of them are not wholesome, but some of like a lot of them are.
It's done. Let's get down to business.
To defeat the Huns. Oh, is this like a mini game? I would love to.
Looks like we finished everything we needed to do. Let's find a good place and put this thing into the sky.
Okay. Oh wow, look at them lanterns. So pretty. Cutscene!
Chi-Chi, we're almost there.
Okay. Oh! Oh, look at them!
Wow. Come here, allow me.
The lantern rises as fast as
my siblings!
Did something happen?
What should we do?
Oh, should we get the Millilith?
How is he on the water? Is he Jesus? Standing on the lantern. Oh, they're all releasing the. Oh. How is she not in the uniform or something?
Have I taken that many pictures already? I need to load more film.
I'm gonna cry. Dig one gameplay though. And Chongyun.
Gaming's performance was so cool. Paimon almost went
against. I was this close. I have tears in my eyes.
Let's go find him. Oh, he's over there, talking to his dad.
This was so cool. Oh my god, I loved it. Where was Ding Wong though? Wait, where are we? Oh, they are over there.
I think I'll head off now, if that's okay?
Thank you, little girl. Do you want us to walk you back?
No need. Master is waiting for me right over there.
This was so cute. I was so hard for crying.
I suppose I'll go first this time.
Okay.
Your performance. I've seen many Wuxio dances in my time, but I've got to admit, what you pulled off there was breathtaking.
Wow. I never thought I'd live to hear you say that.
You're serious about doing this professionally?
Absolutely. I know it'll be difficult, but...
Then it doesn't matter. What I mean to say is, of course it'll be difficult. But if that's your decision, if that's your dream, then it doesn't matter how difficult it is. As long as you put in the work, then any obstacle can be overcome in time. Really, when I was young, I also... Actually, how about we save that story of my past for another time? All I really want to say is, I've changed my mind. Much like this kite, you also deserve to soar to new heights.
Dad.
Oh, I'm not gonna cry.
Son. Son? Haven't heard that in a while.
I bet you're wondering what's gotten into me saying all this.
I mean, is the Lanthornine Spirit.
Well, a little bit, yeah.
Anyway, I know I've never found the chance to say this before, but... to me, Gaming, you've always been a great kid.
This is so nice.
All right, that's everything I've got. Did you have something you wanted to say, or...?
Seeing the two of them talk things through like this really gives Paimon a sense of accomplishment.
This is so nice, an actual hug. Hug it down.
Now go. Over there. Your friends are still waiting for you.
Huh? But you came all this way.
I'll be staying in Liyue Harbor for a bit longer. When you have time, we can grab dim sum together. Your treat, right?
Dad, honestly.
Go.
Okay. Then I'm off. See you soon.
That's quite the smile you've got there, Gaming.
Oh, look at them. They're so cute.
Really?
I want to build this guy.
That's nothing to be embarrassed about.
Is there anything else you'd like to do?
I'd like to find and thank Auntie Xinyun, as well as everyone else who's helped me out. If everyone has time, maybe we could all get together and go fly a kite.
God, I love that. All right, my mom called in the Mimba, so I'll just give her a call back. I'll be right back. Hang on, let me just start some music in the background. Okay, I'll be right back. Thank you. I am back. Hello. I had a good conversation with Mom. Alright, so I don't know where we were.
I see the value in my own work, but I also see the meaning in all the endeavors of the people of Fontaine.
Oh, hey, Charlotte.
I believe I will continue.
Oh, Lantern Rite was simply amazing. I'm not sure I'll be able to sleep tonight.
About the device?
Oh, that? Yeah, interesting story. It was invented by a guy from Fontaine. His name is Ildison.
Ildison?
He's always tinkering that away with some mechanism Nordic? Or another. He's even asked the Steambird to write about his inventions on more than one occasion. I believe I have a direct quote from him about this particular one. Yes, here it is. The device is powered entirely by mechanical components without the need for any additional energy source.
That's weird.
Basically, it's a manually operated cranking device. How high it can fly entirely depends on how much force you can exert. Combining this invention with a kite. What a great idea, right?
All right. What about gaming's father?
My conversation with Mr. Ip went really well. I've already sent the first draft of my article back to the Steambird. It's a piece that contains all the pertinent information while also telling a story. I'm quite proud of it. Oh, that reminds me. I should thank everyone who made this possible for me. Especially that spirited lady with those peculiar turns of phrase. Miss Xianyun was her name, right? It was all thanks to your connections and creativity. I would have never thought I'd be able to bring such a special gift back to Fontaine with me.
Alright then, about Lantern Rite.
This was my first time experiencing a foreign holiday in person. It was so exciting! The festive atmosphere, the contagious holiday spirit, the profound, storied cultural traditions steeped in symbolism. Oh, I almost forgot. Kuching even gave me a kite with a poem on it that she wrote herself!
Aww, it goes, cute!
Dreams are like paper kites. With them do our hopes take flight. Sailing high above the clouds, they yearn for something more profound. Yet try we may and try we might, a deeper truth waits in plain sight. Though we hang our hopes and skies abound, many joys lie on the ground. I want to include this poem in my special feature on Lantern Rite. I'm sure a lot of people will love it.
All right, then, until next time.
And happy Lantern Rite to you.
Okay, so, that's pretty cute, actually. I like this one. Although this thing didn't fly at the end. They didn't let this one fly this time around. That was just, like, there. Oh, why didn't you fly, giant Zhongli looking thing? They are still dating?! These two are my favorite. I love them. Alright, so... Give me some details on this one. Do that? What is that? Yo, happy letter, my do that. Yeah, but I just want to I don't know, I just want to play the game. A pigeon adapter? You're a pigeon adapter? Alright, I want to go to... I want to do the mini game. Please let me do the mini game. Thank you. Okay. I like this. This is so pretty. Bring it up, the dancing queen. All right. All right, let's do this. What's this game's about? Also, why do I have my hair everywhere? Oh, this is that co-op that I haven't done yet. Okay, okay, I didn't read this, but that's okay. Rock on, have fun. All right, let's do some matching. Look other participants away. I wanna lock them away. You know what? I'm fine with fish. Come on, ready up. Also, if they don't bring back Ventress next,
may the glory of the princessin bring light.
If they don't bring back Ventress next patch, I will cry. God, I got knocked back the most. Fuck, but I think I lost. Oh well. That's okay. That's fine. It's fine. This is fine. I wasn't particularly good at these co-op games in the last event as well, when we had that like where you have to kind of like herd the little somethings into your territory. I don't even remember what that game was, but kind of like that. You need to like hurt them into one place. And then you'd win.
I created another universe and founded paradise.
Hey, Evanescence, how you doing? Welcome, welcome. Oh, hey, Kingscar, you're back. Played the second mode and won every time. There's a second mode on it? I didn't realize. Let me just claim my dailies from Catrin. Also, where is the Shincho? Oh, here's gaming! The gamer man. I want to talk to him.
So you're still a big fan of Winter Melon Cake?
There's three in the room. Ah, okay.
Huh? Oh, I guess you heard everything Paimon was saying, huh?
Yeah.
Of course. She was talking about you. As your father, how could I not listen?
This is so wholesome.
Remember
I love this.
When you were a kid, and you would sit on my shoulders to watch the Wuxiu dance. Oh. On our way back home, you would beg me to buy you some winter melon cake.
Oh.
We would only buy two at a time. But before long, we tried the winter melon cake from every vendor that street had to offer. There was also that one time you used your pocket money to treat me. Do you still remember?
Yeah, I remember.
This is so wholesome.
That was the best winter melon cake I ever had.
Let's go back sometime. The shop's still there and I remember the way. My treat, just like before.
Are you sure?
Absolutely.
Oh, this is so cute. Okay, I like this one. This is so cute. So cute. Adorable. 10 out of 10 would adore. Also, where is he? There's a bunch of characters that were just ghosted in this lantern ride. Like, where is Yelan, for instance? Where is Chongyun, Xiangling? Who else is out there? Xiangling here? Oh, Xiangling is not even here. These two are here. Ming Beidou and Yelan were like far up in the background. Ah, okay.
I don't get it.
Is something wrong, Shenhe? Tell me. Perhaps I can help.
The color black doesn't get dirty easily. So I thought this outfit would be acceptable to wear to work. But Xiangling told me it was inappropriate.
Xiangling?
But inappropriate? How?
Why did she just call her Xiangling? It's Xiangling. Xiangling, says Shenhe. Jesus.
She probably just meant the outfit isn't suitable for that particular environment and occasion. But for a festival gathering with friends, a nighttime stroll, or an important banquet, your outfit is more than appropriate, Shenhe.
So you're saying it's only something I should wear in front of important people?
Kind of.
I suppose that's another way to think of it.
I want to visit Xiao at the shrine too.
Thank you for completing.
Okay, I know that Xiao says that he'd be over here, so I'm just gonna come over here and take a look. I want to go up in the Jane Chamber too to have a look. Hang on, let me just change my parties, because this is the claim the daily rewards party. This is the normal party. Oh look, here he is. Hi.
Traveler.
Hi. Just as I thought, you stopped... hang on, what? Just as I thought, you stopped short of stepping into the city again.
Being in the city isn't the only way for me to appreciate the lights and beauty of Lantern Rite. Look. Liyue Harbor lies just beyond this mountain. As long as I stand at this vantage point, I may freely behold the sights of all the kites slowly ascending into the sky.
You can't really see because they are not enough. That they don't go that high up. Alright. Are we getting another romantic moment in between the two of them?
I invited you here because there is something I would like to do.
Do you want to make a child?
I want to release a shell lantern, and I'd like you to be there for it.
Oh, this is a date.
Yes. I apologize for its crude appearance. I have little skill in that regard.
No, it's amazing.
You are very kind, as usual.
Alright.
Alright. It's time.
Aww. I ship them. There it goes! Ah, it despawned. Never mind. As the shell lantern slowly disappears into a tranquil night sky, Shell's expression softens.
Traveler.
Yes?
Thank you.
I'm shipping these two. Incense. Oh, I remember this dude. This was the fake Adepti. What I want to do, I want to find the other guys. What if Ningguang and the others are at the Jade Chamber? I want to find them. I want to find everyone. But there's no one out here, but that doesn't mean that they are not in here. Bam, 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 bam. I kind of forgot where Lady Ningguang's thing is. Oh, she's not here. She's not here. No, she usually would sit over here. Huh? Okay, so Ningguang is not here, but I do believe if I search of where is who. Oh, Baiju is not in this either. But there's a bunch of people who is not in this. Baiju always gets ignored. Poor Baiju. Not like I like him, but I kind of feel bad for him. Oh, would Child be at the Northland Bank? That'd be so fun. I don't think he is. Let's visit Boo Boo Pharmacy to see what we find. Nothing at Boo Boo Pharmacy. Okay. It feels like a treasure hunt trying to find all the characters. Madam Ping. No Madam Ping. Let me know if you see any characters around here. Can't see anyone so far. Nope. 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 Oh, look at all the lanterns! Oh, that's so pretty. Okay, so I don't think anyone else is in. I haven't gone down all the way like this way, so I may as well just go down, have a look, and then after that I'll Oh, there's Cloud Retainer and Ka-ching. Hello.
One may have won the kite flying competition, Yu Hong,
But this prize should truly be reserved for another.
You need not be so humble, honored Adeptus. Among all the kites, yours was quite literally a cut above the rest. Please accept this prize. You deserve
oh,
it.
Oh, because yeah, that's her
I'm
kite that was
certain
a pretty
you
much.
A fair share of the success of this year's lantern rite to you.
If you insist, then one can hardly continue to refuse. However, there is another matter with which one would ask your assistance.
Of course.
One would be much obliged if you could distribute this case of Sunglo tea among the Millilith on duty. The security of the festivities rests entirely on their shoulders, after all.
It was like, I've got so many boxes.
They could always benefit from something to invigorate their spirits.
Cloud Retainer is so thoughtful and attentive to others' needs. I would expect nothing less of an esteemed Adeptus such as herself. Understood. I'll get on that right away.
A fortuitous result indeed. One's tea surplus has hitherto resolved itself.
I thought you would be gifting it to someone. My gosh. Alright. Well, that's nice that I found these two, but I think the... I probably should have a look. It... I don't think there's anyone's down here. That's fine. Let's check. Because Hu Tao is... they said that she'd be here. Yaoqing Village. Maybe Yao Yao is in Qingxu Village? And we can visit Qingxu Village, we can visit Wangshuan to see if anyone's there. I would love for them to... if they would have put Keqing and the others in their festive skins, like how they've done it a few years ago. I don't think they are here though. Can't see them. But they must be somewhere around here though. Why is there such mist? Oh, there's some fire. This one lonely firework here. I want to check at Yilong Wharf. Part 4. I'll do part 4 another stream. It's just nice that I can break it down into multiple streams. It feels like days are actually passing in the story. Alright. Anyone here that I can visit? Referring to looking for who? Okay, well, I will. Hang on. Just want to see if there are any characters here that I'm missing. Otherwise, we can go visit Hu Tao. This lantern vibe thingy here is actually quite cute. It feels very homey, this wharf. Alright, let's look for Hu Tao. Also, Hu Tao in the cutscene was pretty cute. And she didn't rap, so that was a bonus. Where the hell am I? I think I'm going the wrong way. Do you see the Tower of the Who?
Hmph.
This village is so cute. How it's like, it's unorganized, like how the buildings are being built, which makes it feel more realistic. Oh, there's a chest.
Abandoned property belongs to whoever finds it first. So, it's legally yours now.
Alright. Oh, Dao! Oh, Dao! Are you here? Oh, Dao? I don't think she's here. I don't even know where I am. Oh, I know where I am. Okay. This village feels bigger than what it is. I found another chest.
Is it what you wish to find? Hopefully the excitement of opening a treasure chest has at least made it a worthwhile experience.
Tao of the Who? Hello? She might be at the Uncle Luo. She might spawn here after the last part of the quest because I can't see her. And they wouldn't hide her, right? Look, I went through the whole village and I can't find her. Well, that's great. Alright, what I'll do is, like, kill some time. I'll come and get these two bay points. This police letter for me is just like really bugging me at the moment. Imagine if Novilad dies. Imagine if he drowned.
Let the record show that I verbally consent to relinquishing these items into your possession.
Wait, where's the thing? Oh, look at these mountains. Okay. Where's the thing? Wait, where? What? Right, I just need to find the waypoint. It's so pretty. I don't want to bother you. I'll come back to that chest later. It's not the... There's another fucking... Oh my god. There's another cave here. They started doing caves over here too. Wait. What the fuck? Use adapt high energy grain by Fijian to freely move. Jade Harpen. What? What? What the fuck? Okay. Wait, what? What? Huh? Wait, do I have to climb this? Okay. Balance to be restored on both. What? Okay. Spirit Corp Orb. I got the special item here. Not sure what it does, but I've got it. Now I have to figure out how to get all the way up there. Why does it have to give me such challenges? Wait. Where is the waypoint? Found it. This is so pretty. Not sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. Hang on, do I have to climb up? I think so. I'm still not 100% sure what I'm supposed to be doing with these, but... well, at least I've got it. Okay, next stop is this thing. And what I want to do, actually, is teleport here and just walk down this way, because you couldn't walk all the way here before. So that's what I want to do.
Melusines are...
So which way am I supposed to be going?
Beautiful creatures. They are the pride of Fontaine. Be sure to befriend them and cause them no harm.
Is that a threat? That sounds like a threat. My god, this place is beautiful. Okay, that's already Sumeru, I think. And that is Royal Time Harbor. My god, I know the geography of Teyvat better than New Zealand. I swear to god. Wait, I'm supposed to go this way. There, I see the teleport point. And that is the last teleport point that I can see so far. I think. No, there's that one too. And Yeah, otherwise I have all the other ones. Great. What? The sky crab. Let's see. There's some... Oh no, that's just a healer troll. Okay. I was like, the hell is that? Okay. So we got this. That is already Samara. Right. I'll just walk. I'll walk. Because I think I need to go that way. Ocean crab. So much. You know what? No, I'm not gonna grab that waypoint. I'm just gonna, because otherwise I will forget that I have to discover all this area. So I'm just gonna come here and just walk down, see what's there. I don't think they put anything there, but I just wanna see. Alright, now you turn around and you go this way. Before that, you could walk actually pretty far from here. Like, I remember these mushrooms here. But I think this was as far as you could go. Yeah, because that's already leeway. No, there's nothing here. Oh no, this was as far as you could come. See, there's nothing here. But you can now walk here, so I guess that's good. This is like the border of the two. There's no music here and nothing. Oh, there's nothing here. I mean, I expected it. It's quite cool, actually. Like, you're still technically in somewhere here, according to the music. Which makes sense, because over there is Leo. Oh. Yeah, this is Leo. The border of Sumeru. I wonder where these take me. What if I just go up here?
How about we explore the area ahead of us later?
Oh my god.
How about we explore the area ahead of us later?
This is the easy way of crossing. And now we are in Liyue, so on the other side of this waterfall. I mean, it makes sense. Alright. That's it for me for today. That was fun. I wanted to do more, but the quest was longer than I expected, so... yeah, I got a police ticket, the speeding ticket. And that's the most interesting thing that happened so far. Did she just toss you off a mountain? No, I was flying. I was flying and she tossed me off the waterfall while I was flying. Don't worry about it. Alright, I'm going to bed. It was very fun. I enjoyed it. Tomorrow, it depends if I can get a spot in my workout class. If I do, I'm probably not gonna stream. If I don't, I'm going to stream, but I don't know if I'll be streaming Genshin. I might be streaming Genshin, and then on Friday I might not stream Genshin. I stream something else. It just depends. It depends. Why did I just... stop. Okay, anyways. So thank you everyone for joining me today. It was very quiet. Recently, most of my streams are very quiet. I don't know where everyone is. Everyone is busy. No one wants to visit me. It's so sad. Anyways, I love you all. And I shall see you guys very soon. Either tomorrow or latest the day after tomorrow on Friday. All right. Kisses. All right. Hang on. Let me just alt tab out of here. Get some music going. And good night. See you later. Bye.